Namaste students, hamesha khush raho bitiya. I am JV’n's Dr. Neeraj Dholia, Faculty of Agriculture and Veterinary Science, Jayoti Vidhyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. So today we are going to discuss the topic electrophoresis, and this topic comes under the subject upstream and downstream process. So let's start. So the electrophoresis is a technique which is used to separate the biomolecules such as the DNA, RNA, proteins, etc. based on their size and the electric charge. So here an electric current is used to move molecules to be separated through a gel. So the biomolecules have the charges, electric charge, and when they put in the electric field, electric current field, they move towards the opposite charge, and that is the basis of their separation. So here in the process, we use a gel which creates various pore size, and they behave like a shield, and smaller molecules move faster and the larger molecules move slowly. So the conditions used during electrophoresis can be adjusted to the separate molecules in a desired size range. According to your requirement, you can change the size of the gel and the apparatus. So fundamentally, it applies electric current to biological molecules and they separate these molecules into pieces which are larger or smaller. So according to their size, if the molecule is very big in size, you can chop it into smaller pieces. And if it is already in a smaller size, you can go ahead with the original molecule. So it is used in the forensic science, in the laboratories, and in the clinical purposes. So there are also very important in protein research and the genetic mutation research. Okay, so it is used in the genetic mutation research. Why? Because when a mutation is caused in a wild type molecule, its weight or size is decreased or increased. So when you run the electrophoresis for the same molecule, wild type versus the mutant, you will find the different position for the electrophoresis gel. Okay, so it is very widely used in the basic research technique, and was very important for the understanding of gene and protein function. So positive charge, we use the unit which through which we perform the electrophoresis have two electrodes. Okay, so one is the cathode and one is the anode. Means one is the positive electrode and one is negative electrode. So we put our molecules in between that electrodes, and because of the electrode, they feel the electric field and move towards the opposite charge. Okay, so this is the basis of how they are separated out. So when we talk about the proteins in a gel, generally we use the entire protein because it is a small molecule, and it is not needed to chop it in a smaller pieces further. So here, because the smaller molecules have the lesser weight, so it is moved faster in electric field, and the larger molecules move slowly. So in the electrophoresis band, when we observe the band, the bottom side we find the smaller pieces, and at the top side we find the larger size molecules. So SDS page, sodium rhodocyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, it is a electrophoresis technique used for the proteins. And here we use the acrylamide which forms the gel structure. And in the formation of the gel structure, various size of pores are created. We use different percentage of the acrylamide, like 5% to 15%. And these variety of percentage will create the variety of the pore sizes. Okay, so that is required for the different sizes protein. So next, when we talk about the DNA, so DNA is very long molecule. So So we need to chop the molecule using the various enzymes and the DNA into more manageable pieces in a reproducible way. So those pieces, depending on how big the piece are, migrate more or less into the gel further down and box from top to the bottom. So if the size is comparatively smaller, that will the you will found the that molecule at the bottom side, and if the size is the DNA molecule is larger, it will find at the top side. So for the DNA or the RNAs, we use the agarose gel electrophoresis. So agarose again is a polysaccharide which is used to form the gel, and it is again creates various size of the pore. We use to variety of percentage of the agarose gel. Okay, 0.8 to 1.2% can be used, and it will form very variety of pore sizes. Okay. So thank you. Hope you are satisfied with this detailed session. And if you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve your query. This session is powered by digital version 2, Jyoti Vidhyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.